the Hirst legislation, or the Hirst fix legislation it is better known as, is probably the single most important piece of legislation that we need to enact this year, aside from our negotiations on McCleary. This is legislation that's needed because of a Supreme Court decision that basically outlawed the use of our private exempt wells. So if you think about developing a piece of property, building a house, and you're outside of the city, so you don't have access to city services, you need to drill a well. Well, right now you can drill that well, but you can't use that well. And this is statewide. This is not, there are impacts to urban areas, most notably rural areas are the most affected. But the bottom line is the court just absolutely ignored decades of court cases, ecology guidance on domestic wells, exempt wells being a very small use, de minimis is a legal word they like to use, impact on our aquifers, on our streams, and all of that. It has the potential really to ground any kind of development, use of private property to a halt. And you look at the impacts of that, they're huge. You're gonna see incredible tax shifts for those that are gonna have their property reassessed at a lower value because they can't develop it. You're gonna see impacts to local governments. I believe you're gonna see a tremendous impact even into the state in terms of revenue. But fundamentally, you know, folks argue, well, why are you doing this? The court decided this is it. And really, I think as a legislator, we have a duty to act and react, frankly, when the court has overstepped its bounds. I believe in looking at the decision that they overstepped in a way that I believe acting as a legislative body. And so I think for that reason, it is incredibly important for us to push back and to say, look, we understand there may be issues out there in certain areas of the state, but don't broadcast and don't create this tremendously bad policy and put it as a blanket over our entire state. Right now, the legislation's hung up in the House. And we passed 5239, Senator Warnick's bill. We think that that's the best vehicle going forward. They had a hearing in House Agriculture, and we've passed the policy cutoff. And they didn't move the bill out. In fact, actually, a House version didn't get passed out either. So even the Democratic majority in the House couldn't even get their own version of the bill out. So It's incredibly important that people realize what's at stake. We are very committed to pushing to get a policy in place, and we will push with everything we have. But I think it's really important to get the right kind of policy. And right now, I don't want a bill title just to say, okay, this is the Hirst fix, and it really doesn't fix situations that my communities in Spokane are faced with right now. My communities in Colville, in Okanagan, and other places are incredibly impacted as a result of this decision. And so I want you to know that this is a huge issue. We take it very seriously. And frankly, I believe there are a lot of games being played. And I'm hoping at the end of the day that Republicans and Democrats, including the governor's office, can come together on a real solution to a crisis that the courts really, frankly, they've created it. And so we're hoping to fix that. I want folks to stay involved. If you have any particular stories that you would like to share with us, I want those. Those are very helpful as we go along. But I just want folks back home to know not only the seriousness of the issue, but how seriously we are taking the issue and our commitment to find a way forward.